Hi, in this video we are going to install the cable connection Birdhouse camera. As I mentioned before, I prefer cable connection. If wind the cable from the Birdhouse to the router is possible. The reason is because the cable connection camera provides more smoothly video than the WiFi Birdhouse camera. You can reference my another video why we need the WiFi camera. But in this video we are going to use the cable connection. This is the Birdhouse. First, we need to find a path to wire the Ethernet cable from this Birdhouse to the router. Let's just walk around. Meanwhile, I'll take off the Birdhouse, so we need to install the camera later. Okay. Now, let's just move around. From the Birdhouse, we need to find a path to wire the cable. We wire the cable through this hole. This is the hole. So eventually, the cable can pass this wall and enter the house and reach to the router. Okay, now let's move inside and install the camera to the Birdhouse. We'll move outside later. From there, we still get a hole. That's the hole which will allow us to pass the cable, Ethernet cable from outside to inside. So, and this is the router, where the router locate. Let me put back the Birdhouse. And here, this is the camera. This is the PoE Birdhouse camera. You can see you do need the Ethernet cable connecting to this part. And we got the reset button. And this is the DC 12 voltage. That means if you don't want to use the PoE, you can use the DC. But we'll use the PoE, so there's no need for this port. We'll send the power and data through the single cable, single port. And this is the camera. The camera is waterproof, and you can open the front cover and adjust the lens. Just adjust the lens. There's infrared built-in. And from the back end, here we got the built-in microphone, which will pick up the audio from the Birdhouse. This is the 4 megapixel IP camera. So when we use the Wi-Fi version, we just can use the 2 megapixel. It's not because the camera cannot deliver 5 megapixel. The problem is because the Wi-Fi cannot handle such high resolution. And okay, now let's test everything. Test the camera on the mobile phone with the live video before we put the camera inside the Birdhouse before we wire the cable to the outside. Alright, let's see what else we need. We will need this short punch cord. The punch cord will link the router to the PO injector. This is the PO injector. You see we got 2 ports. One is the PoE port, the other is the LAN port. The LAN port is supposed to connect to the router, and the PoE port will connect to the camera. So this PoE injector will supply the power to the camera. We don't need to have the power source at the edge. Okay, here we've got the cable, the 20 feet international KFIE, or it's KFIE Ethernet cable. Okay, now let's just make the connection. First, we are going to power up this one. Let's see, just need to power up the, let's put here. Now the PoE injector is getting the power. We need to connect the first short punch cord. Let me release the punch cord. And from the LAN port, this is LAN port, and connect to the router. Router, we got the data port, this is router. Okay, now the PoE injector is getting the data. The next thing is we need to use the 60 feet KFIE Ethernet cable so we can connect the camera to the PoE injector. Alright, the total is 3. This is the end we can connect to the like PoE port. Okay, we got the camera end. From here, we are going to connect to the camera. And this is the knob we need. I just heard the camera making the click sound, which means the camera is boost up. You can see the power indicator is on. Now the data is start flashing. I also can see there's indicators start flashing, which means the camera is working with the router now. All right, there's one more thing before we test the camera. We also want to install the micro SD card. You see, the camera has the micro SD card slot. We can install the micro SD card and save the live video to the camera. But we need to disconnect the power before we install micro SD card, otherwise it's not going to work. This is the right direction, the pin should face to the lens. Okay. One. I think I don't need to use the screwdriver. Okay, I think it's good. Alright, now let me connect back to the PoE port. Meanwhile, let's get the mobile phone. Before we test the camera, we need to make sure both camera and the mobile phone is connecting to the same router. Okay. Let's go to the app. From here, I use local login. First, click the app button. From here, click the other way to pair the network. And we got the device in the LAN. So now the app will try to discover the camera within the same network. I think this is the camera. And just click to add. Now click to view the camera. Okay, I think the camera's live now. We are seeing the live video from the camera. All right, now the camera's live is connecting to the network by using all the cable. It's time to mount this camera to the birdhouse. So eventually we can wire the cable from the router to the tree and hang the camera and birdhouse to the tree event. Okay, now I need to disconnect everything. The cable. Also, let's just mount the camera to the birdhouse. This is pre-installed bracket. We need two screws to mount the camera. The first one, tap to the middle. Okay, now the second screw. I think the camera is good. This is not to let out the, see, it's not so tightly. This is not to let out the cable. And from here we can use the lighter cable cleat if we want. But okay, the next thing is now let's wire the cable. You need to wire the cable from the PoE injector and go through the room and go to the tree, so eventually we can watch the live video on the mobile phone. Alright, I'm going to put the cable through the hole and my friend will help me to pull the cable from the other side, so it may take a while. Now we have hopped the camera to the tree. And the camera's live on my mobile phone. You see, this is live video from the camera. Okay, I can just open the birdhouse. And here's my hand, right? This is my hand. And there's several things we need to pay attention when we wire the birdbox camera with the cable connection. First thing is, make sure the connector is this direction. You see, it can keep some water out, but it's not completely waterproof if you just upside down, the water may sneak into the connector and damage the connector eventually. The second thing is just cover this reset button and if you don't need, so keep everything out. If you can put some like the enclosure to protect the whole connection, it will be better. The second thing is about the Ethernet cable. Actually, this is just a standard K5 Ethernet cable. You can use the K5 or K6. The maximum distance from the PoE injector to this birdhouse can support up to 300 feet. So it's not just so short distance, you can use long cable you want. You don't need to use this original cable, you can use any K5 or K6 Ethernet cable. You can provide both power and data. So there's no need power source around this birdhouse. Alright, that's all for today's video. If you have any question, please leave a comment section below. See you next time.